And basically, I'm just going to roll into introducing Sasha, who's our first speaker of the day. She is an incredible woman who I think has a very, very powerful message to share. She's a professional coach, facilitator, and strategist. Sasha Herman is the powerhouse founder of the Work Happy Company in Vancouver. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce Sasha and welcome her to the stage. Thank you, Sasha.
How are we doing this morning? Good. Okay, we might come back to that in a minute here. So my name is Sasha Herman. I'm so happy to be amongst all of you amazing humans here today. Full transparency, it can be a little nerve-wracking to be up here. So I might get you guys to help me out here in a minute. I'm here to talk about the business of being human. And the thing about being human is that in order to thrive and survive, we need to feel a bit of a sense of connection. Now, when you're here looking out over there at what could otherwise appear to be a room of stone cold killers, it can be a little freak out. So this is what I'm gonna ask you guys to do. In just a second here, I'm gonna ask you to turn to your neighbor. We're gonna do three things really quickly. You're gonna introduce yourself, you're gonna tell each other today's gonna be a great day, and you're gonna high five each other. So name, today's gonna be great, high five. And even if you bond over the fact you think this is stupid, that's already a win. So please just take a quick second, introduce yourself. Today's great day, high five. Yes. Great. Thank you very much. All right, we can feel the energy in the room, already a little bit better. Amazing. Thank you very much. Hopefully you guys are feeling a bit more awake, a bit lighter, a little bit more connected. And for the most important part, I see a bunch more smiles out there, which is great. If you would be so kind and to keep radiating them up this way to the stage, I know I and probably all my fellow speakers would really appreciate that. So thank you. Okay, let's get going. We live in interesting times. Despite a lot of what we see in the news, a lot of what might appear to be darkness, I really do believe that there is an awakening happening. So, you know, our customers, our employees, and we as individuals are demanding something different from our lives. I don't know about you, but I know that I want a different experience for my own life. For me, it's an experience rooted in what the Japanese call ikigai, which is really about more meaning, more beingness, and more exploration of this bigger thing that we're all a part of. Personally, it also means to me breaking free of what I always thought I should do, of what I always thought I needed to do, of the expectations that I think everybody has of me. I did it, I got the corner office, and I found it to be highly overrated. And what's more important to me, personally, is to be brave, which includes being here in front of you all today. It's being true and living in alignment to what's most important to me. And the thing is, I actually don't think I'm alone in that. We see it across the trends. I first noticed it really with this whole idea of the digital nomad, where people were really desperate and screaming for more experience and freedom and flexibility. More recently, I don't know, it's a conversation around fulfillment, and we see a ton of stuff around the notion of happiness. That's manifesting in a whole bunch of different ways. The minimalism train is now well out of the station, and that's a reflection, I think, of people really wanting to move away from buying stuff, and they're now buying experiences. Part of that is, you know, this desire for more connection. Again, as human beings, we need that to thrive and survive, and self-expression. And I don't know if you guys went to any this summer, but the festival culture has just boomed in the last year. I think in BC alone, I counted 15. It's really all spirituality, meditation, mindfulness. Organizations are getting it. They're talking about being conscious. They're talking about emotional intelligence. And our customers are demanding it from us. They want these conscious businesses. Businesses that mean something, brands they can engage with, and brands that are creating something tangible for their well-being. So it really is a mountain of blog posts and books and blogs around this desire to feel better, to have a different experience, whether that's connection and happiness and meaning. And this awakening that we're seeing, this makes me very, very happy. You see, I'm in the business of people potential, and I really do believe that we all have available to us the potential to change the world. And I think it's because we have this yearning for more meaning that we necessarily will change the world. So that's what I'm here to talk to you about. It's the idea that we are human beings first. and that by connecting to our hearts and to our sense of humanity, we necessarily get to create for the greater humanity. And in doing that, we not only get to change our own experience, because after all, what is the point, if not our experience here on Earth, but we also get to give customers exactly what it is that they want. And what they want is authenticity and realness and something that tangibly improves their life. Companies, you know, like Tom's and Tesla and Patagonia and REI, this amazing baking company in the US called Greystone, which is revolutionizing their hiring and their human resources approach. Startups like Simple Habit, Credit Stacker, which has been in the news a ton, are already figuring it out, right? And it's really the idea of mission and money. And the thing about mission is that it doesn't come from here, it comes from here. And so it's the idea that by connecting to this place, this humanity that's within us, and all of what's going on here, which are emotions, we actually get to tap into a huge, powerful source of inspiration and also information. And when we allow ourselves to kind of connect to this place and start to understand our emotions, that's also where we get to hear our intuition. It's that subtle, wise part of us. And it's the idea that when we get to that place and we can lead with our intuition because it is wise, and then engage our heads because that's what ultimately helps us take action, that we can create something much, much more powerful. And so let me explain that for you. We like to believe that we are thinking beings that sometimes feel. And in actuality, we are feeling beings that sometimes think. The left part of our brain, our thinking brain, is all very rational, all very important. And yet, the longest, most badass nerve in our body, which connects through all of our organs, ultimately connects right up into the right part of our brain. And as you probably know, that is a part of our brain responsible for creativity, strategy, innovation, wisdom, intuition, and also the part of our brain where we find our inspiration to create. And the thing is that we actually in life experience everything. We feel everything. We have visceral reactions to everything, even if we aren't aware of it. In fact, our emotions are so integrated into how we operate that neuroscientists, one in particular, Antonio Damasio, keeps showing over and over and over again that when the emotional center of our brain is impacted, we cease being able to make decisions. So we're talking about like everyday things, things like it's taking people, regardless of their IQ or their previous experience, hours deliberating over what pen color to use to write a check, days over which hotel room or restaurant, I mean, that might happen to some of us anyways, but it's everyday decisions that are otherwise made impossible. And so what they're showing is that if we thought that we were rational beings making rational decisions, every decision is actually emotional. It's what ultimately ends up tipping the scale and moving us forward to action. So, just as an example, I don't know, you can be in a job that's fine for a really long time, or you can be in a relationship that's fine for a really long time, and fine's actually a super dangerous place to be for, and a lot of us find ourselves there, myself included. And it isn't until your boss humiliates you that you decide to quit, or maybe that your significant other cheats on you, that you finally break up with them. It isn't until there's an emotion that really starts to happen for you that you move forward to action. So all this to say, emotions are super, super powerful, and the moral of the story is this. We experience everything, and what we experience, what we feel, connects right up into our brain, into the creating part of our brain. And whether we're aware of it or not, it shapes our decisions, it shapes our behavior, and ultimately it shapes what we create. So it's the idea that what it is that we're experiencing now and in this moment, and what's happening for us today ultimately dictates what we create for our future. So what does it mean? Whatever happens today shapes what we create for our future. I'm going to illustrate that for you. So these are very extreme examples, I know. But if what we're experiencing in our life is fear and anger and isolation and disconnection, we perpetuate that. We create walls and wars and torture and Columbine. We come together in hate and we destroy. If, however, we turn our eyes inward and we connect to the sense of our heart and our humanity, there's redemption and reconciliation and things like the ending of apartheid, the coming down of the Berlin Wall, we get to create, and there's possibility, green cities, and Pixar is born, bionic limbs, and ocean-creating machines, and startups that can potentially change people's lives. And the cool thing, too, is that we end up coming together to talk about humanity and the future. Oops. So if experience is everything, and we experience everything, then how do we tap in, how do we use this really big force that we have going on within us to tap into the best version of ourselves, the strategic, creative, future-changing, business-building version of ourselves? And it's two things. The first thing is that we need to become aware of what's happening for us. So 99% of us spend 99% of our lives living from the neck up. And so the first key thing is to really, and it sounds super simple, but it's reconnecting to our bodies. And in doing that, it's understanding and tuning into what's happening for us, because if we're not paying attention to what's going on for us, good or bad, and it's important to let yourself have all of it, we just start reacting. We're not aware of the decisions that we're making, we're not aware of what it is that we're creating. So the first thing is, hey, what's going on for me? And then the second thing is choice. So that's deciding where it is we want to operate from. And that doesn't mean that our head and our hearts are at odds, but it's the idea that we can, by tuning into this, understanding what's happening for us, understanding what it is that we're reacting to, choosing to listen to our intuition because it is wise, our hearts because that's what means something to us and that's how we connect to others and we build for others, and then executing with our heads. I kind of liken it to music. So our hearts are kind of like the melody, the rhythm. They're what get us up out of our chairs and get us onto the dance floor. And our heads are like the lyrics, the poetry. They're each beautiful in their own right, but when you bring them together, they create meaning beyond our understanding. And so I'm gonna get us to experiment here a little bit with this idea of what it means to actually connect to our bodies and connect to all that information so that we can start to create from that place. So if you will indulge me, this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna do it with you. If everybody could please close their eyes. And if you would, if you could put your hand on your chest, whichever hand feels right, ideally making contact with your skin if you can, that would be great. So if everybody with eyes closed could take a deep breath, what I'm gonna ask you to do is to focus your attention on your hand. And with your hand, feel the skin below it. So taking a breath, what is the temperature of your skin? Is it cool? Is it warm? Is it soft? Is it rough? And as you breathe and connect to your hand, feel your chest rise and fall below it. Taking another deep breath, shift your attention now to the skin. And from the perspective of your skin, feel your hand. Feel its weight on your chest and your fingertips pressing into your skin. And is your hand warm or cool, rough or soft? Is it moist? Is it dry? And taking another deep breath, go back to your hand now. And if you would, feel beneath your skin, into your chest, and feel for your heartbeat. And as you feel for your heartbeat, keep breathing. If you can't feel it, don't worry about it. Just take long, beautiful, deep breaths. And as you connect to your heart, think about a time for which you are truly grateful. A beautiful moment in your life. Moment of gratitude. A time where everything was good, where you felt connected, where there was love, inner peace, a beautiful moment in your life for which you are grateful. Important moment in your life. Let yourself enjoy it. Just look into your heart, my friend. That will be the return to your a powerful place for you. A place from which you can change your life. A place from which you can change the world. This isn't just positive thinking. This is what it means to have vision. We're all leaders in this room. We need to do better. As leaders in this room, it is our job to do better.